আসসালামু আলাইকুম ওয়া রাহমাতুল্লাহি ওয়া বারাকাতুহু। আলহামদুলিল্লাহি রাব্বিল আলামিন ওয়াল আকিবাতু লিল মুত্তাকিন ওয়াস সালাতু ওয়াস সালামু আলা রাসূলিহিল কারীম আম্মা বা'দ। Well, praises be to Almighty Allah, who has been given us the opportunity to attend this Islamic program that called Salafi Conference of Al-Jamia Salafia, Dangi Farah Bawar Ash-Shahi. So he says, Alhamdulillah. And peace be upon the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who last and greatest prophet and the final guide of mankind. So he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah also bless this gathering, our respected principal Shaykh Abdul Razak bin Yusuf, and all those men who made his conference a reality. So Allahumma Ameen. Honorable chair of the program and venerable listener of Salafi Conference, now I want his speech in this topic, who is fixed for the committee of Salafi Conference, perform two rakat of Salah before sitting after entering the mosque. I will speak this topic, inshallah ul-Aziz. This practice is contrary to Sunnah. One has to sit after offering two rakat of Salah when the Imam is delivering the khutbah. The hadith which is propagated in favor of prohibition to against offering Salah at that time is counterfeit. That's about an Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, La tusallu wal imamu yaktubu, La tusallu wal imamu yaktubu. Narrated by Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Do not perform any salat when the Imam is delivering the khutbah. The hadith, do not perform any salat when the Imam is delivering the khutbah. The narration is forgotten. Moreover, it directly goes to another hadith and write, Al-Numar is dakhla adukul masjidah, ala minbari fala salata wala kalama hatta yafruqa al-imam. Narrated by Numar radiallahu said, I heard Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, when of you entered the mosque and the Imam is going to be delivering the khutbah, he should neither perform any salat or nor speak until the Imam eats the sermon. The narration is rejected. Shaykh Albani said, wa inna mahkam tola al-hadithi bil-butlani ma'azofin sanadihi wa yukhalifu hadithayin osoyiyayni. I have been forced to the hukum of being rejected in this hadith because the sanad is zayif. In addition to going another sahih hadith upright, open the book of hadith, Sahih al-Bukhari, volume number 1, page number 127, and hadith number 930. And Jabirin call, Dakhala rajulun yawmal jumadani nabiyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa yaktubu. Narrated by Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one day a person entered the mosque and the day was Jumu'ah and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam delivered the khutbah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked that man, have you performed two rakat of salah? The man replied negative. Then Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, stand up and perform two rakat of salah and then sitting. Imam Bukhari composed a paragraph, Babu izar wal imam ja rasulunahu yaktum amrahu yusalli rakatayn. If a person entered the mosque and the Imam is going to be delivering the khutbah, Imam should order to him perform two rakat of salah. Imam Bukhari composed another paragraph, if he who comes to the mosque and khutbah progresses, he should perform two rakat of salah. That's about another Sahih hadith upright. Open the book of hadith Sahih al-Muslim, volume number 1, page number 2061. And Jabirin qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ija ja'ahadukum yawmal jumati, wal imam yaktuhu, fal yarka' rakatayn liyatafawwas bihima. Narrated by Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Will khutbah is progressing. If a person enter the mosque, he should perform two rakat of salah and he should do it in short time. So dear attendants, we understand this speech, when of you enter the mosque, we should perform two rakat of salah. When of you enter the mosque, we should perform two rakat of salah and then sitting. But what do we do? We do not perform two rakat of salah. Enter the mosque before sitting. What kind of Muslim are we? We call out in our mouth, Kalima shahadat, ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu. We wear our cap in our head, but we do not follow hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who does not follow hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a great punishment of hellfire wait him in his afterlife. That's about an Ali radiallahu ta'ala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam la takzibu alayya fa innahu man yakzib ala yalizim nara. Narrated by Ali radiallahu ta'ala said, do not tell a lie in my name, whoever does who, he will go to in the hell. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do not tell a lie in my name, whoever does who, he will go to in hell surely. That's about another Sahih hadith upright, and Salamata ibn al-Aqwa radiallahu ta'ala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَاكُلُ مَنْ يَاكُلْ مَا لَمْ أَكُلْ فَلْيَتَبَوَّأْ مَا قَضَى مِنَ النَّارِ. Narrated by Abu Salamah al-Aqwa radiallahu ta'ala anhu, I heard Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, if one says something that I have not said, if one says something that I have not said, he will make his place in Jahannam surely. So dear attendants, we understand this hadith. We should abide the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of the time we should follow the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whoever of my speech is right from Allah and every mistake for Shaitan and myself. May Allah accept this conference. May Allah accept this Salafi conference, and may Allah accept this our respected principal Shaykh Abdul Razak bin Yusuf and all those men who made his conference a reality. Please pray for me that I will be a great alim of the Bangladesh and all of the world. Please pray for me. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.